effort on the Shen had 1,000. Ooh, Bubble's gonna land here. Gonna be trying to line that up, but again, it is a Galio up against a Zoe. So, Pizza doesn't sound anything like Fizz if you're not familiar with Korean.
And they were talking about Pokemon, and speaking of Pokemon, almost caught an effort.
I suppose so. They caught something here. Nova might be able to get out here. The Ignite is ticking. Oh. And one more will do it. The last tick. First Blood goes to effort again.
Yeah.
Actually, two First Bloods.
In your jungle.
I am a Rakan with no disengage. Please do something. And it actually happened.
They go in here. Effort. He's bruising. Gets out and disengages. But look at Blank. Flashes in. He gets the target that also will be further stunned. And they go for the Wombo. Launching the Galio, ends up being a waste. He gets an assist, though, for all of this, and apparently someone died. Soon I'm going to be talking about going to work up hills each way.
Yeah, we're getting close. Speaking of getting close, this Infernal Drake is close to going down, but Nova gets sucked down again with no summoners and engaging now onto Ornn as Sohan has nowhere to go. Had his flash, but didn't even bother to use it. A 2-0.
And the Infernal to SKT. We don't get a replay of what happened off-screen. They'll need any O.J. Simpson moments as Umti comes through and starting off the Searing Charge. Nicely done from Sohan. He tanks it up. This is perfectly executed by Jhin Air. Unfortunately, as a counterpoint, Blank zooming around but doesn't have flash as Umti goes in.
They're looking for the engage onto the Braum, but he's so tanky. Might be able to still get him though in the back line, but the talk comes in. It's perfect to save his life. That might be the only one. Baker, though, charging ahead as he has slept up there. Grace trying to carry in and get that damage onto Blank. And Blank, unfortunately, this time around.
And no Wombo. Things going well. Can they actually close the distance here?
No flash there, but they're just going to grab Umti, who may have got himself into so much trouble here. No, he does get the stopwatch down, but the Ornn coming in from Sohan. He makes it into the mid lane. It's going to be blocked by Effort.
Oh!
Huge three-man taunt by Faker. Here's Nova going to charm a lot of members up, though. Faker is going to get low, but here's Tall in the back line. Is able to take one member out and have his passive popped. That will be a 2-for-1 in favor of SKT.
Plant some Pope. He's had a pretty poor season. Again, he's had teammates that have also had that. It's onto Umti.
Umti, this time he doesn't have a stopwatch, and that's just going to be the free kill onto the jungler. So, nothing but great mountain drakes, or just drakes in general for SKT.
Umti clearing that ward, which the close to the wall was already super risky, and then he gets hit by a Braum Q and dies. I think the first mistake was as a melee champion trying to clear that one. You don't have stopwatch, you know the enemy Skarner's flash is up. That's already a mistake. Again, in the end, it's chair shot. Whoa, it's not the time. It's not the confession time.
Hey, man, I'm just saying. They're going to get the double taunt here and an easy kill onto Umti once again. Teddy now just trying to do the culling from behind the Braum, comes in front, and, well, they get another pick onto the Camille, that jungler, and once again, Jhin Air just walking forward. Might be in some trouble here, not knowing where the Aatrox was. Looking for another engage. They will land the stun, but can't find a kill just yet. Nova, though, getting really low. Gonna miss that True Shot Barrage, unfortunately. They start it, they get seen. They say, okay, instead we'll banner push down the mid wave. Two banners, actually, committed to get this turret down. And a nice taunt once again, actually, in the back line. Was it too much, though? No, it was not, as Nova is actually gonna get pulled there by the Skarner as he tries to counter-engage and disappears off the map.
While it requires his flash, Mega solo zone multiple people, but here's the Ornn ulti. Oh,
nicely done, getting pretty low in the back line is Bang. That's gonna be the Braum going down. Galio, though, still very, very healthy alongside Tall. Is gonna have that passive popped, and Grace still available, but he's low on mana.
In the fight, at high health. He was eventually chunked out, only Grace was able to clean up a single kill. Baker makes a big investment. You'll notice that he uses flash for this double taunt, and it does a lot because it does keep Teddy and Umti down, gets them a pick, but they can't fully disengage because this time Umti walks up. The Ornn ultimate actually gets maximum value because Unbreakable was visibly used on screen by Effort. Perfect time for that ulti. They knock up four. That's a strike for the side of Jhin Air, but they can't necessarily get a big win from this. As Tal starts the zone, Teddy is DPS'd out. A couple more items on some of these Jhin Air members, and these fights for SKT that we kind of threatened would be a little bit less one-sided in a higher gold game. We're getting closer to that higher gold game.
We'll see if this works out for them. Double TP coming on in.
He's out of the fight.
He is going to get super low.
They're going to go back on it.
Sleepy Trouble Bubble coming in. Might be saying thanks for the leash, the taunt there, and it is going to go over to Blank with the nice spike coming in. And Tall now looking for an engage, but he is going to be Sleepy Trouble Bubble down, and there is the Arn Ultimate. Going to go on to two members. Bang trying to do damage in the back line, and Oopsie and Nova get so unbelievably low. Bang looking to carry this fight alongside Faker. Grace and Teddy, though, still alive
as well.
He's just getting so low in that fight. Jhenair really struggling to find a jungler that can be super consistent. He's taken so much from the Baron. And the Ezreal ultimate comes through, nearly kills him.
And now it's a 4v5. The Baron starts. Umpty knows there's no way in. If you watch Effort, trying to just set this all up. He uses his Unbreakable, though, and that's why the Ornn ultimate seems like it's the perfect timing again. This time only hitting two. Faker interrupts Nova as he was about to get into the fights. There is no further CC onto the back line. In hindsight, Grace and Teddy were so far back that maybe it wouldn't have mattered. Grace and Teddy desperate for a front line that doesn't big fan of this item build. Is Bang might just ult first target? He does.
Well, it's only the two of them down here right now, but Faker does have a nice amount of damage. Here's the quickness coming in. Bang! That's what I was talking about. The Zoe just blowing him up. Now the calling coming in. Blank getting a little bit low there.
The game goes on. We've seen Bang try to take the shortest route. Speaking of routes, they just want to kill Tall, apparently.
Yeah, Tall are going to go in on this one because he can't go out, but one versus three.
It's going to take a while, by the way. He also has GA. Out of memes. Sorry, guys. Pack up the memes. They're done.
Oh, boy. Not going to put up the Unbreakable effort. Oh, that's not fortunate there. And here we go. Ornn is going to have to be flashed. Here's Empty thinking about engage. They don't want to go too deep for effort. Jumping on him with a dark flight, and they are going to get onto Empty, who will have his GA popped here. Tall getting low, but not just yet. Nova trying to go in with the quickness now. We still got Teddy and Grace in the back line.
Watch Teddy.
They're trying to do that damage. Teddy, though, is going to be jumped on by Tall, and they finally take him out. Grace here still alive, and he is going to chunk down Faker. Trying to get that last auto. Can't quite do it. Trying to carry the fight just by himself on the Zoe. We've seen it happen before. Trying to jump down the Tall, but somehow he gets away. With the flash.
He would come in with the paddle star. A few to the face means that Zoe no longer has presence. And, didn't see any UIs pop up or anything like that.
Tall is in a really good fight position. Here we go.
Trying to get onto Empty once again. They're going to be able to burst him down. And Tall in the back line. Unbelievable damage. Having the help of Bank to come on in and secure the kill onto the Zoe. That might just be game here with Baron. SKT looking for the mid lane.
And it's time for them to roll through. You notice Teddy goes mid lane, wants to stop the minion wave from coming. That's where the teleport comes topside. They want to catch Nova. He also jumps over the wall. They don't have a minion wave. Really well played by Teddy to cut it.
Yeah, nicely done there. Looks like they're going to look towards top lane. Might not be able to end the game, but they still have about 30 seconds here on both Grace and Empty. They can at least get two inhibitors and maybe even more.
Both teams make the right read. Killing the minion wave in the mid lane slows them down, but they find a second one. They still want to end.
Yeah, they do have a bit of time here, 20 seconds, and the double Bannon minion in the back line. They definitely want to end this game here. They do not want to let it go any longer and let the Zoe and the Lucian try to come back. Zoan, though, trying to end this one or stop the push at least. He will lose his life. But now SKT getting a little bit low here. The culling coming in. Teddy in the front line trying to burst them down. They're all so low, but they are going to get the Nexus in the end. 46 minutes, and SKT is finally able to get a second win. Secure that 2-0 for today.
They needed to get over the line today. This was their chance against another team with no match wins, but they sure had to work hard for it in game number two. Now is not the time to celebrate. You play too many times per week to count this as a grand final victory, but SKT fans will be celebrating. Their team is away from their drought. They have won their first match of the season. Things to work on from game number two, but game number one showed innovation. Game number two was an eventual closeout of a much more standard composition. And while the optimism will not be sky high, playoffs looks like a long way away, You can only win against who you're assigned. And today, SKT with too good for Jin Air Green Wings.
You take it one step at a time, right? Jin Air's not looking fantastic, but SKT, they'll take the win, and they should take that confidence with them. It was a lot cleaner in game number one. Game two looked like it could have gone the way of Jin Air multiple times, but they just could not execute and take the win. So SKT, take your win, take it home. You know, maybe have a drink or two, congratulate yourselves, but then get right back on that horse because you have so many more wins to get to if you want to make it to playoffs.
Seems that their standard play is the stuff that needs to be cleaned up. Execution in the mid game let them down a little bit. The innovation stuff has worked, and I think we 8-12 coming next week. There's still plenty of room for funnel. We saw plenty of funnel in the EU and the.